Okay, logarithmic functions. You have never seen this in your life except for paper. You're gonna learn this in pre-calc, crazy in pre-calc, okay? You're gonna have to do a bunch of math with it in pre-calc. But in applied, we don't do much with it other than just graphing it. But what is a log? Okay, this is a log form, and it's the opposite of an exponential. So if I ever did, this, you don't have to write this down. Okay, if I ever did this log 100, okay, there's a secret 10 number here. Okay, here's what it does. It says, what is the exponent that makes 10 to a something end up being 100. So this is what your brain is doing. So what is the value of log 100?
2.
This would have to be a 2, right? Okay, so let's test that theory out. So you have a button called log. So here it is on the sideline. Log 100. So you can type that into your calculator, log 100. Everybody find that button? Equals, and there it is. Okay, so this is an exponential, like this is exponential. This is me thinking logarithmic. So what it's doing is it's changing our input output. So this would have 2, 100, and this would have 100, 2 as a point. It's just switching the points around. Okay? So here's the next thing I would know if you want to test something out. Log 1,000. What should that be? Because remember, your base is 10 to something turned into 1,000. 10 cubed. Look, that's why it's that. So that's just what a log is doing. Okay, pre-calcers, you're going to have all this figured out. Applied, you just have to have a general idea. Okay, so we're going to graph this function. So when there's nothing there, it's assumed that there's a 10 there. So you don't actually put the 10 there, but I'm telling you there's like a magic secret number that's a 10 down there. So go y equals log x. And then we'll zoom 6 it. Okay, so I don't really need all this. I'm going to change my window. I don't need much to the negative side, so I'm going to actually go negative 5, and then I'm going to go like 30. I'm going to change my scale, my tick marks, to 5. I'm going to go negative 5 to 5 on the heights. And this is the shape that I'm getting. Okay. Does it make sense that there's an asymptote there? Remember exponential functions? I'm just going to flip back to your notes. Remember, exponential functions had a flat asymptote. So this is opposite, so now it has a vertical asymptote. Okay, can you get me this coordinate right there? So I'm going to second calc the 0. Did you get one there? Okay. The x-intercept is 1. Ooh, what about exponential? What was happening here?
The
y-intercept was 1, unless something changed it, but... So the y-intercept was 1, and now the x-intercept is 1. Okay, and then there's the next point on this would be 10, 1. Does anybody know the next nice whole coordinate I would get to? 100, 2 would be like way over there. That'd be the next. So can we say that this is growing very slowly? It took me over 100 to get up to a height of 2. That's growing very slowly. Okay, let's put a coefficient in front. So I'm going to throw in a 2 in front of that. So go back to your y equals screen. Does everybody know that you have an insert button? I'm going to go second delete, which is insert, and then I can just put a 2 in the front without putting it over to the top. Otherwise, you'd have to retype. So you can insert stuff using that button. Graph. It looks very similar. What is this point? Did it move? Stay? Where is it?
How do we find this point?
Calculate the 0. Left bound it, right bound it. I still got mine at 1. It didn't move. Okay, so what is the 2 going to do to change this graph?
Change the slope.
It's going to kind of change the rate of growth. So guess what I'm going to do? I'm going to hit 10. Trace 10. Now this coordinate is 10, 2. So it is growing faster a little bit, right, than the last time. So this coordinate 100 would now be 100, 4. It's going to times by 2. Okay, we're not going to graph. Let's predict. What do you think 5 log x would look like? So my prediction is the same shape. My prediction is 1, 0 is still going to be that intercept. But now something's going to change. This coordinate would be 10, 5. Instead of 1, it'd be hit a height of 5. Okay, because it's getting times by 5. The heights are getting times by 5. Okay, so this doesn't change because if you times the height of 0 by 5, nothing happened to it. The heights are changing. Okay, so you can't change a height of 0. So 100, what would it be? 10. Because the original was 102, so now the 2 height turned into a 10 height. Let's talk about domain. Let's talk about range. What's the domain? How far left do we hit?
Not quite 0.
Not quite 0, so 0 bracket round. To the right, we go forever right. And then the range, how far down would we be going? Forever up. It is going up. It's slowly, but it is going up, 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 up. Okay. Let's look at something else here. What if we do a negative number? Let's see what happens there. So graph me that one. Negative 5 log x, what does it look like? I'm getting that shape. Okay, so x-intercept. What do you think about the x-intercept? It's still 1. What do you think about the y-intercept? Where is it going to touch this line?
Never.
Never. Domain, so what's the domain of this shape? 0 to infinity. Range, everything. And then end behavior, so it's going from what quadrant to what quadrant doing what? So I would say it's going from quadrant 1 and then into quadrant 4 as it decreases, because we flipped it. We flipped that shape. Okay, one more. How about 12 ln x? So everybody find an ln button. It's right under your log button. So the ln does this. You don't have to worry about it too much until you're in pre-calc, but instead of using a base of 10, the ln, which is called natural log, so ln, it must be French, log au naturel, natural log, and it uses that base e. So it's opposite of the e exponent, just like how log was the opposite of the 10 exponent. Ln is the opposite of using an e exponent. Okay, but we're just worried about its graph. So I'm going to zoom 6 it. And I got that kind of shape. If you need to change your window, maybe a little higher. Okay, so the log shape, that's what's happening. What do you think about the x-intercept? Still 1. It will never move as much as you multiply, because you can't multiply 0. Y-intercept, still none. Domain, what do you think about that? Same. Range, same. Quadrant, this would change a little bit, right? Which quadrant are you going from to, and what are you doing? So we are going from quadrant 4, and then we move into quadrant 1, and we increase. Okay, so do you see the pattern of it? What does the very back side of your whole notes booklet look like? Is it blank? It's blank? Okay, let's write stuff on it. Back side of your notes booklet. Let's go. Okay, give me a chart. We're going to do a T-chart here. Graph. I'm going to be doing this. Graph an exponential log, x-intercepts, y-intercept, domain, range. Those are the kind of important notes about them, right? And this is everything. This is your whole unit. Oh, let's go asymptote. Okay, ready? Exponential functions. We actually had two types. We could have been doing this, or we could have been doing this. That's what it would look like. Okay, do you remember that? So this was an exponential that increased. So what made an exponential increase? If the this number was doing what?
Bigger than one.
Base. If the base number was bigger than one, it would increase. And then this exponential, if the base number was less than one, it would decrease. And now we know the basic log shape. That's the basic log shape. So this is the whole unit. You have to know these characteristics. Exponential and log shape. Okay, so asymptote, exponential, this is the asymptote line right here, right? We never touch it. What's the equation of that line? How do you make a flat line? X equals or Y equals is flat. Y equals zero. Log, this is your asymptote line because you're going to get closer and not touch. So this line would be X equals zero. Exponential, what's the x-intercept? There's none, right? You don't touch that line. You don't touch the x-axis. What's the x-intercept over here? 1. What's the y-intercept? So where did it cross the y-axis? At 1, unless there was a coefficient, right? That kind of changed things. But otherwise, it would have been at 1, unless there was a multiplying number. Where's the y-intercept on this log? None. What was the domain of this? Left, right. Forever, right? What was the domain of this one? 0, right. 0 to the right. What was the range of this one? 0 and up. And what was the range of this one? Negative infinity to infinity. So what are we noticing with all this? Everything is swapped. X's and Y's are being swapped around. So the domain of this is equal to the range of that because the X and Y swapped. So the X stuff here is the Y stuff there. Swapped. The Y here is the same as the X there. The X here is the same as the Y there. Okay? X and Y properties are just flip-flopping. That's what happens with these graphs. Okay? Okay, so last question of your booklet, and then we're done. That would be on your test, like the generic properties, without your calculator. I'm going to have a without your calculator section. Okay, so here is a chart, so you guys know we're going to be doing L1, L2 stuff, right? Here we go. You have to read your variables. Let X represent the time in decades. So, starting with X equals 1 for 1900. So 1900 is actually just 1. This would be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Let Y represent the corresponding life expectancy. So we're trying to figure out the life expectancy of people over time. Okay, so give me. Everything's the same here. Stat edit. Up, clear, down. Stat edit. So in your X, your L1, you can be doing 1, 2, 3. Okay, so L1, L2. So I need you to go Y equals. We'll clear that. Activate plot. Everything's the same. Zoom 9. Okay, so if I say draw a scatter plot, you kind of would just give me a general picture. Don't go crazy, just a general picture. With what labels? What are your variables again?
Decades.
Years, decades, and then life expectancy. So the life expectancy is going up, right? Slowly, our life expectancy is going up. That's the trend, right? Okay. If I was to ask you what function your scatter plot looks like, what would you be picking as the shape? What function? It would be a log function. Okay? So we're going to go stat calculate. Okay? This doesn't do log. This does natural log. So this would be option number 9. Please don't mistake it for linear. You see this? This is linear, this is LN, natural log. It's close, and so don't get mixed up. How come this has two of those? Does yours have that? Linear?
Yeah.
I wonder what...
It's because one's
AX and the other is BX.
Oh! I don't think I've ever used that. I've never used option 8, so don't push option 8. Okay, option 9, linear regression, or not linear. Logarithmic regression. So I've been asking you to put your equations on your test. So don't forget Y equals. Lots of you did that. Y equals 42.53 plus 13.86 LNX. That's how you would write what you see on your screen. Everybody's matching that number? Coming out? Okay. Everything else is the same. Ready? We're going to Y equals. Copy paste. If you want, you can see how the graph that they've chose models our data very well. Get it out. And now we do the work that we are asked to. Okay, question. Predicting the life expectancy in the year 2030. So 2030 is a year, so that is me dealing with x's. But be careful, x is not 2030. What would x be in the year 2030? 14. So what are we going to do? We're going to go trace 14. That's your work on your calculator. Trace 14. Are you getting a quit? Okay. What's the problem if we get a quit? Problem is our window. The highest our window was at 13, so I got to make it a little bit more than 14. So I'm just going to go 18. So trace 14. So the life expectancy of people is 79.1 years of age.